Welcome to the morning service. We are glad you are here. Please join us in opening the service by singing Bless the Wonderful Name of page 51 in your hymn notes. Bless the wonderful name of Jesus. Bless the wonderful name of Jesus. Bless the wonderful name of Jesus. Remind us that inwardly we are being renewed day by day. Show us that with our problems we can still hope in you. Help us to fix our eyes in you in times of trouble. Lord, you love us, and by your grace you have given us eternal comfort and hope. Now comfort and strengthen us in every good thing we do, and say, in Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Bless the wonderful name of Jesus. Bless the wonderful name of Jesus. Bless the wonderful name of Jesus.
Participating in our devotions. Next song, He Got the World in His Hands.
Thank you. that our God can do, He can do it.
Come forward.
Give, give, give.
given in Jesus' name. Give, 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 given in Jesus' name. Give, 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 given in Jesus' name. And the Lord will bless you.
Great job, Pepe. Great job. I want to say good morning to each and every one of you. Amen.
Good morning.
Good morning, Pastor.
Good morning, everybody. Amen.
Good morning.
This is the day that the Lord has made.
And let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Amen. Give the Lord some praise. Amen. Amen. And before we get into the Word of God this morning, I want to thank all the men and young men that came out yesterday for the men ministry meeting. Amen. We had about 12 men, Johnny Green and our brother, Johnny Green, Deacon in Training, and our brother Deacon Melvin Brown headed it up. And it's a beautiful thing, and they're going to do some good things with that ministry. Amen. You know, I love God for answering prayers, y'all.
Yes, he does.
And if there's a need, God would always provide us that need. As long as we're living our lives the way he has called us to live our lives. And Brother Green and Deacon Melvin Brown has been a prayer. My brother Derek, man, I was so happy to see you yesterday. Brother Derek is coming. You know, the thing is that we need to know that Jesus Christ is on his way back.
Yes.
And we need to be in line or in tune with him and not the things of this world.
Amen.
Amen.
And it starts in the body of Christ. Mm-hmm. We have to know what we know. Amen.
Uh-huh.
We have to know that Jesus loves us.
Yeah.
And we need to be on his game plan and not ours. I don't care what the world may tell you or what the world may teach you. It's only one way.
Yes.
And his name is Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Don't get twisted up in the politics who you vote for and things of that nature. Don't get twisted up in the leadership of this country. Because there's only one leader when it comes to us.
Amen.
There's only one way that it comes to us. There's only one president when it comes to us.
Yes.
And
yes.
His name
yes.
is yes. Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
And I want to thank, I met Brother White, or Pastor White, last Sunday. We were at Cattle Burner, and Deacon Melvin Brown introduced me to him. And I had seen the brother somewhere before. I just can't remember where we saw each other before. But we got to talking. So keep them lifted up, him and his beautiful wife. She's a minister as well.
Amen.
Lift it
Amen.
Up in your prayers. Amen.
Amen.
That they find a church home.
Amen.
Amen. Like I told him, I can always use a preacher, somebody to come, two or three to come preach the word here. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So we'll keep you guys lifted up in prayer. Amen.
Amen.
I'm happy to see Sister Linda and Dale Brantley back permanently. Amen. At least that's what they say. That grandson doesn't fall and they'll be gone.
Amen.
Amen. But I'm happy they made it back safely from Galveston, Texas. Amen.
Amen.
And Selena, my other daughter. I am so happy to see you as well. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And Sister Charlotte's niece, right? Amen. Good to see you guys again and your son as well. Amen.
Yes.
Amen. Now, if you will, Sister Wanda, you have a little guest there too as well.
Oh. This is Justice.
Justice, all
and
right.
Justice came for the weekend.
Okay.
I picked her up from school on Friday and she'll be going home today at 1 o'clock, I think.
Okay.
So you may be seeing Justice even more.
Okay. Praise
Amen.
God.
Amen.
Praise God, praise God, praise God. Amen. They are our future.
Amen.
And we got to train them up, like the Word of God says. Train them up
yes.
in the things of God.
Yes.
Now, if you will, turn your Bibles. Turn your Bibles to Romans chapter 8. Good. Romans chapter 8. If I can get everybody to stand. Romans chapter 8, verses. And I'll be preaching from verses 36 and 37. Voices.
Have thine own way, Lord. Have thine own way. Thou the potter, I am the clay. Make me and mold me after thy will. Have thine own way, Lord.
Romans chapter 8, verses 36 through 37, says, as it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long, we are counted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us.
Yes.
You may be seated. Amen. The grass withers and the flower fades away, but the word of God will last forever.
Amen.
How many of y'all believe that?
Amen.
Amen.
I would like to preach on the topic, we are more than conquerors. Y'all don't sound encouraged by that.
Amen.
We are more than conquerors.
Yes.
According to the Bible, the children of God are constantly victorious people.
Yes.
We can't always see it, and we don't always feel it.
Yes.
We don't always live like it, but it is true nonetheless.
All right.
Because if you are in Jesus Christ, mm-hmm. we have our victory in Christ.
Yes.
And the verse before us today has brought comfort and hope to the hearts of God's children for almost 2,000 years. It reminds us that we are more than conquerors in spite of the obstacles in our way.
Yeah.
In spite of how things appear to us. In spite of how we may feel about the things that are going on around us.
Yeah.
In spite of we are killed all the day long, we are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Brother Paul reminds us we are more than conquerors.
Yes. Amen.
Not by our own ability.
Yes.
Don't get it twisted. But because of God's love for us.
Amen.
Without Jesus, we can do nothing.
Amen.
All the power is in his hands in heaven and earth.
Yes.
Come on, somebody.
Yes.
What I'm trying to tell you, we are more than conquerors because of his love for
yes.
us.
Yes.
And Romans 8 is one of the most loved chapters in all scriptures. Paul begins and ends with this passage with statements about the absolute security of those who are in Christ. Mm-hmm. First, there is no condemnation at all for those in Christ.
Yes.
And last, nothing will be able to separate us
yes.
from God or for the love, God's love for us in Jesus Christ.
Yes. Amen.
Now, by this, Paul refers to those who have been saved by their faith in Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, Paul is talking about his audience is our brothers and sisters in Christ.
Yes.
He's not talking to the world, he's talking to Christians.
Yes.
And as God gives me liberty, I want to spend a little time this morning in this verse, because the facts revealed in it clearly reminds us that we are more than conquerors.
Yes.
See, I'm trying to encourage you this morning and let you know, I don't care what's going on in your life.
Yes.
I don't care what you've been through or what you're about to go through.
Mm-hmm.
You are more than conquerors in Jesus
yes.
Christ because of his love for you.
Yes.
You may not feel like conquerors today. You may have doubt about what the future holds, but regardless how you feel, this verse offers words of hope,
yes.
words of peace,
yes.
and encouragement to those who feel discouraged, defeated, and overwhelmed by
yes.
life.
Yes.
And the Apostle Paul shows us that the facts that are revealed here that teaches us that we're more than conquerors. And the first fact that he teaches us is the reality of our conquest.
Mm-hmm.
Paul uses the phrase more than conquerors. And this translates a word that only appears here in the New Testament. It refers to those who gain a surpassing victory. It means to be completely victorious,
yes.
to carry away an overwhelming victory.
Yes.
It literally has the ideal of us being super conquerors, uh-huh. which means we are more than meets the eye.
Come on, somebody.
That is who God say we are.
Yes.
And I believe everything that God says about you and what he says about me.
Amen.
Amen, Pastor.
But that is not always how we feel.
Mm-hmm.
Most of the time, most believers I know seem to be overwhelmed by life. When Paul writes that we are super conquerors, He uses a tense that suggests a present tense active situation. In other words, he's saying that Christians keep on winning a glorious victory. You see, we can't lose with the thing that God gives us. He is saying that even when all life is arrayed against us, we are super conquerors in Jesus Christ. We were conquerors yesterday, we're conquerors today, and we'll be conquerors tomorrow. So regardless how things feel to us or look to us, we're still more than conquerors. And that is the clear testimony of the Word of God, which tells us in 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 14, "Now thanks be unto God, which always causes us to triumph in Christ and make it manifest the savor of his knowledge by us in every place." Now, we cannot take credit for this victory, because the victory is only found in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And that is why all we have to do is be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. Our thoughts should be that the Lord is on our side, and we shall not be moved. Our thoughts should be that we will accept by faith the promises of God concerning the victory we have in Jesus Christ. Our thoughts should be that God will help us to live out that victory every day, in spite of how things may look to us or how we feel about our circumstances. Oh, talk back if you can. You see, we are more than conquerors. We are super conquerors through Jesus Christ that loves us. So therefore, there's no time for pity parties. There's no time as the woe is me attitudes. There's no time for a defeated lifestyle. I've come to let you know that God said that you are more than conquerors in Jesus Christ. And if God said it, I believe it.
Hallelujah.
So don't allow the enemy to lie to you or get you riled up, steal your joy or steal your peace. Because my Jesus says we will always, constantly, perpetually have the victory in him.
Yeah.
And you need to know what God says about you.
Yeah.
You need to know with full confidence what he feels about you. You need to know with confidence who God say you are. And he says that you are more than a conqueror.
Yeah.
So that is the conquest of that is the reality of our conquest. But the verse also tells us of the rim of our conquest. Paul says that we are more than conquerors, but he also says in all these things. Most of us have the idea that victory occurs when we are living lives that are free from troubles, free from afflictions, and free from heartaches. But the reality is, we live in a world that brings trouble, it brings afflictions, and it brings heartaches to our front door every day.
Amen.
Say amen if you hear me. But Paul says we're super conquerors in spite of all these things that the world and the devil can throw at us. So Paul, what are these things? Well, in verses 33 through 35, Paul says, "Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is God that justifies us.
Yeah.
Who is he that condemneth? It is Christ that died, yea, rather than it is risen again, who's even at the right hand of God, who also makes intercession for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress, or persecution or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword?"
Yes.
So what are you saying, Brother Paul? Paul is saying we are super conquerors in spite of those who charge us.
Amen.
We're victorious over all those who would challenge our relationship with the Lord.
Yes.
God has justified us, and nothing will ever change his mind.
Amen.
You see, when Jesus died on the cross for our sins, and we came to faith in him, God the Father justified us, which means we're not guilty of all the charges.
Yes.
You see, come on, somebody, that ought to make you want to shout.
Yes.
Everything that you did in your past, God has forgiven you for if you came to faith in his Son.
Yes.
And I'm not just talking about past sins. I'm talking about present sins and future sins.
Yes.
Now, let me say, we don't practice sin, but you better believe, long as we are in this flesh, we're going to stumble into sin.
Yes.
Come on, somebody. But God has already forgiven you when Christ died on the cross for you. So if God justified you and me, No man or woman can hold or lay any charge against you.
Amen.
They can say what they want to say and do what they want to do, but we belong to Jesus.
Yeah.
You see, people will try to get you off your course. People will try to distract you. People will lay charges against you and say they're supposed to be a Christian. But if once you come to faith in Jesus, you are his, and it don't matter what man says. Now, Paul also is saying we are super conquerors in spite of those who condemn us. We are victorious over those who would declare that we are unworthy before the Lord.
Yes.
Jesus Christ died for us on the cross and shed his blood to save us, and no one can undo what God did for us.
Yes.
On the cross.
Yes.
In other words, we are covered by the blood of Jesus.
Yes.
You see, you may stumble in your walk, and they may say you're supposed to be a Christian. Mm-hmm. You may fall from where God has placed you, and they may say, I told you they were a fake. You may trip up in the things that you say and do, and they may say they are no different from us. But who can condemn us? It is Christ that died for you and me, and we are covered in his blood. Paul is also saying we are super conquerors in spite of those who confound us. The world and the devil has always been and will always be the enemies of the children of God. And their attacks are frequent and they are severe. You see, they attack our minds through fear. They attack our well-being through false hope. They attack our peace through lies, and they attack us through confrontations. But in spite of everything they throw in our direction, we are still victorious over all the efforts to defeat us and to destroy us. And let me ask you, how do they try to defeat us and destroy us? Well, it's right here in verse 25. Paul says, through tribulations. And this means to be squeezed or to feel pressured. This is the common problem all people face.
Yes.
And if you ask Job, he will tell you, man that is born of a woman is of a few days and full of trouble.
Yes.
And if you ask Jesus, he will tell you, these things I have spoken unto you, that in me you might have peace, but in the world you shall have tribulations.
Yes.
But be of good cheer.
Yes.
I have overcome the world.
Yes.
Through distress. Literally, a narrow place. It means to be hemmed up or cornered by one's circumstances. To be trapped with no way out. Through persecution. Suffering inflicted on us because of our relationship with Jesus Christ. Through famine. A lack of necessary resources. And this is the natural byproduct of persecution. Through nakedness. A lack of proper clothing. To be in a state of destitution. This is also a byproduct of persecution. Through peril, the threat of imminent and awful danger. Through the sword, the threat of murder. The cold, hard, death-dealing instrument that sent many believers out into eternity. But Jesus said, if the world hates you, ye know it hated me before it hated you.
Yes.
Paul says, all that will live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution.
Uh-huh.
But we are more than conquerors.
Yes.
Not by avoiding these things, because these things are going to come. But by the victory over them through Jesus Christ.
Yes.
You see, our pain and our suffering is very real.
Mm-hmm.
But so is God's purpose in our life.
Yes.
Now, we must remember that his plan for our lives and our plans for our lives is rarely the same plan.
Yes.
They say, if you want to make God laugh, tell him your plans.
Yes.
In God's plans, the things that we go through, he is refining our life.
Yes.
For 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 7 says that the trials of your faith, being much more precious than the gold of gold that perish, though it be tried with fire, might be found unto praise and honor and glory at the appearing of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
So just as a goldsmith heats the ore to remove the impurities. God uses the trials and afflictions of life to get rid of us, or to rid us of the imperfections and impurities of the flesh.
Yeah.
He is remaking our lives. When he is finished with us, we will be less like ourselves and more like his son, Jesus Christ.
Yeah. Yeah.
He is realigning our lives.
Come on now.
Paul says in 2 Corinthians chapter 12 through verse 7 through 11 that God is working in us to bring us to the place where life ceases to be about us.
Uh-huh.
And all about him and his will for us.
Amen.
You see, the process is very painful, but it's very necessary.
Yes.
If God is to be glorified in our lives. We must remember that God will get more glory from our lives when we are being purified than he will if we are allowed to live lives of ease. You see, in God's purified process, we will come forth as pure gold.
Yes, yes.
You see, that truth can be seen in Job. That truth can be seen in Paul. But if you look at yourself,
yes,
that truth can be seen in you,
yes,
because you are not the same person that you used to be.
Yes,
you see, you can't change yourself, but when you come to faith in Jesus Christ, yes, as you are, he will do the changing.
Yes.
All we have to do is submit and be found faithful in the things of God, and whatever is burdening us, Jesus will take that burden, and he will clean us and take all the unrighteousness far from us, so we can be just like him.
Amen.
You see, how many of you can testify that you wasn't even this, you know, today you're not even the same how you were yesterday, or a year ago, or months ago? It had nothing to do with you, it had nothing to do with your mama, it had nothing to do with your daddy, it had nothing to do with Big Mama and them, it had everything to do with Jesus Christ. And let me say, and when you're going through the process of refining, the process of remaking, the process of realigning, you will pray more.
Yeah.
Oh, come on, somebody. Yeah, come on. And I often say this, if you ain't praying, you playing. When you're going through the process, you read and study the Bible more.
Yeah.
When you're going through the process, you will not have time for silly people or silly things.
Yeah.
When you're going through the process, you're more than likely to seek the Lord more and not the things of the world.
Yeah.
When you're going through the process, we're more likely to do these things when the heat is turned up on our lives.
Yeah.
But allow me to say, don't run from it, just turn up.
Yeah.
Turn up on you. And that is just reality. And that is why the Lord sends trials our way. For the word says in Psalm 103 verse 14, for he knows how we are formed. He remembers that we are dust.
Yeah.
Just as it takes time, heat, and pressure to transform coal into diamonds, it takes the same circumstances to transform a sinner into a saint.
Yeah. Yeah.
So we have the reality of our conquest, the rim of our conquest, and my final point, the reason for our conquest. Paul tells us that the only reason that we are victorious in this life is through him that loves us.
Amen.
Oh, give Jesus some praise. Our victory does not lie within ourselves. Our victory does not lie in worldly leadership. Our victory does not lie in what we own, how much money we have, or who can give us the hookup. Our victory only lies in Jesus Christ. You see, you cannot claim and declare something that you do not have the power to do.
Amen.
You cannot speak nothing in existence. Right. You cannot claim and decree anything. It's Jesus with the power.
Yeah.
And it's God the only one that spoke, and it came into the world.
Amen.
Because Jesus has all power in his hands in heaven and earth.
Amen.
And that power is shown toward us because of his love for us. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Consider for a moment what we deserve according to the word of God. It says the wages of sin is death.
Yeah.
Then think for a moment about the nature of his love for us. He says, call unto me, and I will answer thee and show thee great and mighty things which thou knowest not. Then stop and think about what did he do to prove his love for us. while we were yet sinners, while we were yet sinners, while we were dead in our condition, while we were heading straight to hell, Christ died for us. There's no greater love than this, a man that dies for his friends. The love of God for his children is so vast, it is so deep, it is so far-reaching that God wants us to know that nothing can come against us and separate us from his great love for us.
Amen.
And verses 38 through 39 are a commentary on the depth, the breadth, and height and length of God's love for his children. Paul tells us that none of the things mentioned in these verses can separate us from the love of God. And the word separate means to divide. To put asunder, to divorce, to put away.
Yes.
And the word able means to have power. Mm-hmm. In other words, none of the things people fear so much has any power to divide us from his awesome love.
Amen.
When we go through those things, we need to be assured in our hearts. And when I say our hearts, I mean our mind, body, and soul.
Yes.
That even the pains, the sorrows, and afflictions of life are evidence of God's love for us. Paul had his share of the trials and the torments of life. For he has, for 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verses 23 to 28, let us know, Paul was in stripes above measure, in prison more frequent, in deaths often. Of the Jews, 5 times received I 40 stripes except one. 3 times was I beaten with rods, once I was stoned, 3 times I suffered shipwreck.
Yeah.
A night and day I have been in the deep, and journeys often in perils of water, and perils of robbers, and perils by my own countrymen, and perils by the heathen, and perils in the city, and perils in the wilderness, and the perils in the sea, and the perils among false brethren, in weariness, and painfulness, and watching often, and hunger and thirst, and fasting often, and cold and nakedness. But those things that are without, that was coming upon me daily, the care of all the churches. Through all the things Paul went through, he tells us in verse 38 that he is persuaded. And that phrase is in the perfect tense, which means that Paul stands convinced and nothing can change his mind about the matter. He knows that God knows what he is doing and that the saints of God can count on the boundless, eternal love of Jesus Christ to see them through whatever they may face in this life. That was Paul's prayer for the Ephesian believers, and it is God's will for us today. So we are more than conquerors, but we don't have to do anything to assure our victory.
Amen.
Victory is ours because the Lord loves us and promises us that his love is the guarantee of our conquest of all the things that may come against us. Let me break it down for you. You may feel like the world and Satan is beating you down. You may feel like you're stuck in a ditch of hopelessness. You may feel like you're stuck in a ditch of discouragement. You may feel like you're stuck in a ditch filled with depression. Somebody may be saying, I'm tired of struggling with this world. I'm tired of fighting this spiritual battle. I'm tired of failing in this fight with the flesh. I'm so tired of being sick and tired. Well, what you need to know this morning is you are more than a conqueror through Jesus Christ that loves us. You see, when you feel damaged, depressed, and dogged out, you are more than a conqueror. When you feel doubt, deceived, and denied, you are more than a conqueror. When you feel anguish, when you feel afflicted, when you feel worried, you are more than a conqueror. I'm just telling you who God say you are. When you feel tempted, tried, and tortured, you are more than a conqueror. When you feel outcast, overlooked, and overtaken, you are more than a conqueror. Our victory is found in Jesus, who loved us. And although you may lose some battles with sin and self, he still loves you. Although you may lose some battles with doing things his way, he still loves you. Although you may lose some battles with the things that you should not be doing or some things you should not be saying, he still loves you. Thanks be to God, we give us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Tell me, who can stand before us? Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? Who is he that condemns? Who shall through Jesus Christ that loves us.
Yes.
So don't worry about what you're going through or what's going on around you.
Uh-huh.
Don't let the fear overtake you. Don't let uncertainty take away from what God has promised or has planned for you.
Yes.
Don't let the world give you false hope, because when Jesus...
Yes.
When Jesus is on our side,
yes.
When we're living our life for Christ,
right.
when we came to faith in Christ, we need to know. We need to know that we know that we know that victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory today is mine. I told the Savior to give me new life. Victory today is mine. Praise God for the one who was hung high and stretched up wide. Praise God for the one who was pierced in his hands, who was pierced in his feet and his side. Praise God for the one who bled and died on the cross that we may have life. Put your hands together for Jesus. Praise God for the one. Come out for 3 days and 2 nights, got up in the grave because the grave could not hold him. Praise God for the one who now sits at the right hand of the Father, who makes intercession for us and tells Satan, the accuser of the brethren, know that one belongs to me. Praise God that we are more than conquerors, super conquerors, because of Jesus who loves us.
Yes.
That's the Lord.
We're living in a time right now that it seems like the world has lost its mind.
Oh, yeah.
And let me tell you, they have lost their mind. Mm-hmm. But our hope is not in the world.
Amen.
Our strength doesn't come from the world.
That's right.
Our peace doesn't come from the world.
Yes.
Our joy does not come from the world.
Right.
All we are, all our hope is in Jesus Christ and Jesus Christ alone.
Amen.
If we can get our heads around that.
Yes.
If we can get our heads around that, we're more than conquerors.
Yes.
Which means the fears of this world has no control over us.
Hallelujah.
Everything we need is in my Jesus.
Amen.
Our hope is in my Jesus.
Yes.
My peace that surpasses all understanding is in my Jesus. And we need to know that with confidence.
Yes.
Because we're living in a world that's going to hell in a handbasket. They're trying to influence us on the things of the world, and they're trying to bring the world into the church. But the world has no place in the church unless you want to be saved.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Unless you want to be saved and come to faith in Jesus Christ. And let me ask you, are you convinced that you are more than conquerors?
Amen. Amen.
You see, I don't know about you. Sometimes we forget who God says we are. And if God says it about us, y'all, we need to believe it.
Amen, Pastor.
We need to trust in it. And we need to be confident in it.
Amen.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
You see, if you are saved, you are more than a conqueror.
Amen.
And as we prepare to open the doors to the church, let me say this. I've been struggling, and y'all been knowing about my struggles. And I say that because I don't always feel like it's true that I'm more than a conqueror. I ain't going to tell you any lies. I'm going to tell the truth to shame the devil. We all struggle. We all struggle with the things of this world.
Amen.
And I don't always look like it is true that I'm more than a conqueror. But the Bible assures me and it assures you that we are. Now, I'm interested in that truth becoming a reality in our lives. And it can be, but we must take God at His word.
Yes.
And learn to trust Him by faith.
Yes.
Even when nothing that is happening in us or seem to us to back it up. In the end, victory comes down to faith.
Amen.
Either I believe what the Bible says or I believe what my eyes see. What my mind thinks or what others say. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Live your life with Jesus. Don't live your life to please man.
Amen.
Live your life to please Jesus. So my fellow super conquerors, we are more than meets the eye. What should we do with this information? I think we should seek the Lord's face. and ask him for faith to live like a super conqueror, even when we don't think that that is what we are. You see, I think we should seek his help to live in victory, even when we feel defeated. I think we should just take God at his word and leave the details with him.
Yes.
I think we need to let go and let God.
Amen.
Listen to the third in the Godhead that's inside of you, the Holy Spirit. Submit to him, and he will order, guide, and direct your footsteps.
Yes.
Listen to that voice on the inside of you.
Amen.
And let him bring you comfort. Let him remind you of the things of Jesus' teaching. You see, we're finna go to battle, y'all. We're finna go to battle. And we're in a spiritual warfare right now.
Yes.
The world is trying to take our mind, trying to take our children, trying to take away our hope, take everything away that God says that is ours. And we need to know that. And as you come to your feet, we need to know if God be for us, who can stand against us? I believe what God says about me. And I believe what he says about you.
Amen.
You are more than conquerors. And as we open the doors, if you would like to come for prayer, please come. If you would like to come to be a candidate for baptism, please come. If you would like to come and be a born again a believer, please come. Just know whatever you need. You know, a lot of people say when two or three gathered in the name of Jesus in the midst. Yes, he told that to his disciples. But we have Jesus in us right now.
Amen.
Paul said, I show you a mystery.
Yes.
The Jesus Christ in you.
Yes.
Which means Jesus is right here, right now. So whatever you need, please come. Know that because of his love for us, we are more than conquerors.
Amen.
Amen. The doors of the church are open.
Thank you.
Amen. Amen. I'm going to ask Pastor, want to come up? We're going to pray mainly, it's just prayer. Amen. Amen. I'm going to pray. We're going to lift up my daughter, future son-in-law. I'm going to get married in 2 weeks, all right? In 2 weeks. And we're going to pray that they keep Christ focused and center of their marriage.
Yes.
Amen. We're praying for our sister Ingrid here and her daughter Sarah. Amen. We're just praying for comfort and peace, and that prayers, that the prayers that they've requested from God be answered.
Amen.
And safe travels to Chicago. Amen. Am I my friend?
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory be to your name, Lord.
Amen. Amen.
You are worthy to be praised.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. Heavenly Father, gracious Lord. We come now lifting up this beautiful couple before you, Lord God. From the beginning, you said you've created Adam and Eve. And Father, you said he who finds a wife found it a good thing. And I pray in favor with you. Father, I pray for your favor to rest upon this family. I pray, Lord God, in the coming days that they'll find a new thirst and hunger for you, Lord God. I pray for my dear brother, Lord God, as the head of the house, Lord God, that he will not just be head in title, but he will be head in spirit as well. Father, I pray that you will strengthen him and comfort him and fortify him to be the head of his home, Lord God, seeking you above all else. Father, I pray for his wife, Lord God, that the two will come together and be one in the spirit, Lord God, one in the flesh, Lord God, that what you join together, let no man put asunder. Father, we plead the blood over them, Lord God, that you will continue to keep and watch over them and strengthen them, Lord God, in the coming day, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, Father, we thank you that they saw fit to join in union where we're in a time where so many look down upon marriage. But Father, you said marriage is honorable in all. So Father, we thank you for the honor. We plead the blessings upon them. We pray your wisdom upon them. And Father, we pray for your comfort to be with them in the name of Jesus. Father, we count it down in your name, Father God. Father, I pray for this dear sister and her daughter, Lord God. I pray, first of all, for safe travel and mercy upon them, Lord God. Father, I pray for my dear sister as she travels back to Chicago, that you will watch over and keep her, Lord God, just as you did when I was a youngster, Lord God, growing up in the south side of Chicago. Father, I pray that you will love and protect her with your ministering angels, Lord God, to stay in garrison about her and keep her, Lord God, in the coming school years, Lord God. And Father, I pray for this mother and daughter, Lord God, that you continue to strengthen the bond of truth, Lord God. And Father, for that unspoken request, you know the hearts of the Lord God. I pray that you will meet the need right now in the name of Jesus. Father, we come against all spirits of confusion. We bind the work of the hand of the enemy who will try to kill, steal, and destroy. But Father, as your word has been spoken and declared today, that we are more than conquerors in thee. So Father, I thank you. I bind that word into them, Lord God, that they will walk in the fullness of this in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We give you the praise, the honor, the glory. In the name of Jesus, we count it down.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor White.
Amen. Amen.
And as we come to our feet,
amen.
Keep each other lifted up in prayer. Amen. We need to know that this warfare is real. Satan don't want the world. He's already got it.
Amen.
So if he can trip up God's people, God's children, that's his full mission right now.
That's right.
Because it's time to finish short. Jesus is on his way back, y'all. And we see it in everything in the world. So don't let him trip you up. Don't let him run to you. Don't let him steal your joy and peace. Amen, somebody.
Amen. Amen.
lift up Jesus, abide in him, and he will abide in you. So keep yourself lifted up in prayer. Let's pray for one another. Let's pray for one another. Amen. Now to him that is a power to establish you according to my gospel and the preaching of Jesus Christ according to the revelation of the mystery which was kept secret since the world began, but now is made manifest and by the scriptures of the prophets, according to the commandments of the everlasting God, made known to all nations for the obedience of faith. To God only wise be glory through Jesus Christ, for now and forevermore. Let the children of God say,